extraterrestrial habitat pictures that you see in magazines and such or on television, they don't look as realistic as they need to be. The biggest issue is the hazards that these habitats are going to have to deal with. Things like meteoroids, Marsquakes, sandstorms, and radiation. RETH is about developing smart habitats that are able to respond to the changes and the hazards and all of the things that could go wrong during a space mission. What happens when there is radiation exposure? What happens when there is a Marsquake? What happens when there is a sandstorm? How do we maintain a habitat that has to stay within the boundaries of supporting life while also being able to do science, while also protecting occupants? We have to keep that functioning no matter what. Thrust two is, how do you build sensors and instrumentation and health management systems that are going to be able to diagnose what is going wrong when and if something goes wrong? We're also incorporating robotics. So the robots are going to be doing various tasks regarding the science, but they will also have to deal with the maintenance issues as well. So if something goes wrong and you have to go out and repair something, do we have the robots that can do that autonomously? Up until now, we've done a lot of simulations. We're aiming to build a quarter-sized habitat that would be partially virtual and partially physical. Hybrid simulation is mixing computer models with physical specimens and running an interactive test in a big control loop. And so by doing this type of testing, we can test the parts that we don't understand, but we can put into our computer simulations the parts that we do understand, and the interaction between those is what we can really focus on. This builds upon all the history here at Purdue of having the largest number of astronauts, and we're very excited to have this chance to propagate this forward, build a new area of expertise. Ultimately, the goal is to serve humanity, right? The habitats are there to serve humans for exploration in the future, and also that are probably going to have significant ramifications here on Earth, helping us here on Earth to be better prepared for hazards, earthquakes, hurricanes, and we can better respond and be prepared for those types of events.